2, 1. Okay, so undefined or indeterminate. All I want to talk about in this short video is the difference between two cases which kind of look like a fraction. So you have some number divided by zero, and you have zero trying to divide by another zero. These are two special cases. These are actually not numbers. They don't belong to any set, but they do serve a nice purpose in math. And you should know that one of them is called undefined, and then the other one is called indeterminate. Now, the one on the left-hand side, when you have a non-zero number, so we will assume that this n is non-zero, because if it was zero, then we would be back to this case. For that, if n is not equal to zero, we call this undefined. And whenever this happens, if you're, for example, solving something within math, this would have no solution at all. On the other case, when you run into zero over zero, which may happen, this is called indeterminate, meaning we cannot actually determine what the answer could be. And that's not very useful if we're trying to solve something and we don't know what the answer could possibly be. So that is the distinction between undefined and indeterminate. Now, because we cannot determine, doesn't mean that there is no solution. Sometimes this means that this can have many solutions. The unfortunate part is that because it has many solutions, and we cannot determine maybe which one it is, it may not be as useful as knowing an exact number. So again, so the one on the left that you see when you see a number, and it can be any number. It can be a negative number like this. It can be a positive number like this. It can be even a decimal number like this. So any of these would be undefined. But if you see 0 divided by 0, then we call that indeterminate. And that's all that I want to talk about in this video. All right, thanks for watching. See you in a future video.